Hey students, welcome back. In this short video, I'm going to show you how to make a simple platform game similar to the one you see on the screen. Let's get started. All right, let's get started with our platform game. Let's create a blank new Scratch project and call it platform game. Let's get rid of the cat sprite, and we're going to make a real simple sprite. So come here and choose the paint brush option. We're just going to take the rectangle tool. I'm going to have a purple color, and I'm going to just draw a simple square. If you hold the shift key down as you're drawing that square, it will make a perfect square. Zoom in a bit. Using the select tool, select the entire thing and make sure that X is right in the center. And make sure the stroke here is about set to 6. We want a black stroke around a purple center with a stroke size of 6. We're going to have two costumes for this main sprite. So I want to just create two little eyes and a mouth. This is my character facing to the right. And now I'm going to duplicate that. Select it all, flip it horizontally, and call this one left. Now we're ready to start coding our player. Let's first call our sprite player. Pull out a when green flag clicked. We needed several variables that will control the movement of our player. Let's go to the variable palette and make several variables. We're going to have X speed, Y speed, gravity force, bounce force, points, and that should do it. We can turn the visibility on all of these variables off, except for the points. Let's move this points up here into the upper right corner. When we start our game, we want our player to be located down in this area. We're going to set the player's location to negative 145 and negative 130. We're also going to set his size to about 80%. When the game first starts, we need to set our variables. So let's, again, on the variable palette, pull out a bunch of these set blocks. We'll need 5 of them. We need to set each of the variables that we just created. We're going to set X speed to 5. That's going to be the speed that the player moves to the right and left. We're going to set Y speed to 0. Gravity force should be set to -1. We're going to set bounce force to 10. And finally, let's set points to 0. Now, whenever we go to a new level of the game, we want the player here to go to what's called his home position. Again, we set that to negative 145 and negative 130. So we're going to create a custom function here in the MyBlock section. Click on Make a Block. Let's call it Home. Click OK. To define Home, we're going to go to the Motion palette. Let's pull out a Go to X and Y block and make sure the numbers are correct for the position for the player. Now, when you define a custom function or a MyBlock, you need to call it in order for it to be used. So go to the MyBlock section, find the home block, pull it out here and add it to the when green flag clicked function. Now, no matter where our character is, when we click the green flag, he should always go to his home position. Now, before we can go any further, we need to design our backdrops. Let's go to the stage, click the backdrops, and choose the rectangle tool. I'm going to choose a light blue background color, no outer stroke, click and drag and create the blue background. Remember, the stage where the game is played is represented by this thin white line. So that's the edge of your game. Choose a brown color. Set the stroke to be black. Move all 3 sliders to the far left. Set the stroke size to be about 8, and then with your rectangle tool, draw your first platform. Now, it's very important when you draw these platforms for the background that the outline is a black line and that it has a nice thick line, at least 8 pixels. When you draw this first one, make sure that it's located just a little bit below where your character is located in his home position. Let's go ahead and draw the rest of these platforms. You're going to want to arrange them as follows. Something like that will do. Okay, that looks good. Now, this basic platform game is going to have 2 backdrops. So let's come up and right-click on our first backdrop and choose Duplicate. And now we have our second one. We're going to change it up a little bit. First of all, let's take this bottom section and copy it, then paste it. Then let's go ahead and move it over to the right. Let's move the one on the left a little bit this way. We want to have a gap in between these two platforms, and we want to put a big lava pit in between. So let's change our fill color to a red, turn off the outline stroke, that's important, choose the rectangle tool, and draw our hot lava pit. This is an area where if our player falls into that area, the game will be over and he'll be placed back in level 1. Again, make sure the positioning of this first block on the left is low enough that it's right below your player when he's in his home position. Now let's rearrange these blocks a little bit differently. Make sure you have your select tool. Grab the blocks, move them around. We want some of the blocks to be further away to make it a little bit more difficult for the player. Something like this will make a great layout for the second backdrop. Now we're ready to start coding our player sprite. So with the player sprite selected, go to the code view. We're going to control the movement of our player with custom functions. Let's go back to the MyBlock section. We're going to make 3 new functions. Let's call them move, jump, and gravity. Let's start with the move function. The move function is going to control the movement of our sprite when we are moving to the right and left only. We need 2 if blocks. Inside that, we're going to use sensing blocks, checking for when a key is pressed. For the first one, let's do the right arrow, and the second one, left arrow. When we press these keys, we first want to cause our sprite costume to change. So when we press the right arrow, let's switch the costume to right, and vice versa when we press the left arrow. So we've defined a function, now we need to call it. Let's go back to our control palette, pull out a forever block, place it here under home in the when green flag clicked function, and bring out our my block for the move function, place it right inside the forever block. Okay, let's test it. When I press the green flag and press the right and left arrow keys, I see that the costumes switch on my character. He doesn't move yet. Let's do that next. Let's choose a change X by block. Place them there. We're going to change X by X speed. When we're going to the right, we're going in a positive direction, so we change X by X speed. However, when we're going to the left, we're going in a negative direction. So we can say change X by 0 minus X speed. Let's save our work and test. Now our character moves to the right and left. Now we notice when we test our character, he doesn't fall down into the lava pit and he cannot jump. So we need to add those sections next. When he gets to the far right, he also stops there. We want it so that when he gets to the far right, he goes to the next level of the game. Let's do that next. Add an if block right below the move block inside the forever loop and add a greater than operator block. In the movement section, find the X position of your player sprite and ask if the X position is greater than 235. Remember, the far right side of the game window is 240 pixels, so we'll test for the far right edge a little bit less than that, 235. If your character gets to that point, let's send him back to the home position and change to the next backdrop. Under Looks, Next Backdrop. Let's save our work and test. Now when the character moves to the far right, as soon as he gets to that far right, the backdrop will change. And since we only have two backdrops, it just keeps switching from one backdrop to the next. Now let's add gravity and jumping to our player sprite. All right, now let's define the gravity function. The first thing we want to do is change the Y location of our sprite by Y speed. Next, add an if-else block and ask if our character is touching the black color. Remember, we said earlier that you need to make all these platforms have a really thick outline of black. And the reason for that is because we need to sense if our character is touching that black color. The only black in your game should be the outline of the platforms. So let's choose the color and make sure these are all pulled all the way to the far left. They should all be zero. Now in the else clause, put a change Y speed by gravity force. Now if we take our gravity block and put it inside the forever loop right below the move block, and test our game, we should see that our character begins to move down with the force of gravity. Perfect. However, if our character is touching the black color, the outline of our platforms, we don't want him to move down. So let's do that section next. We need another if-else block inside the first if statement. And here we need to ask if Y speed is less than zero, meaning a negative number. We need another variable here. We're going to call it ground. It represents the position when our character is on the platform and he's not being pulled down by gravity. If the Y speed is less than zero, which means it's a negative number, then we will set ground to a positive number, 1. Else we'll set ground to negative 1. So what we're doing here is we're either, based on the current value of Y speed, we're setting this ground number to either 1 or negative 1. Now add a repeat until right below the else clause, but still inside that first if statement, and tell it to repeat until it's not touching the black color. Again, you must pull all three of these all the way to the left so that they all say zero. And in that repeat until block, we'll change Y by the value of ground. And finally, add one more set block below the repeat until, but still inside the first if statement, set Y speed to zero. Okay, that should do it for our gravity function. Let's do one thing before we test this. Let's select the stage and go to our backdrops. First, let's rename our backdrops Level 1 and Level 2. Let's go to the code view, pull out an event block when green flag clicked. And when the game first starts, we want to switch the backdrop to Level 1. Click the green flag, and now it should be switching to the first backdrop. Now when we test the game, sure enough, when we get to the far edge of one of the platforms, our character falls off and goes down with the force of gravity. However, when he hits the bottom of the screen, we want him to be placed back to his home position. Let's do that next. Choose the player sprite. Add another if statement and place it here underneath the existing if statement inside the forever block. Using a less than operator, ask if the Y position of your sprite character is less than negative 170. Remember, the bottom of the screen is considered negative 180, so we are determining if the sprite has moved almost to the bottom of the screen, and if so, we want to put him back to his home position. Now when our character moves to the right and falls off the platform, he will automatically go back to home. Perfect. Now to finish the player sprite, we need to get him to jump. Let's define the jump function here. Add an if statement. If the up arrow is pressed, we want to change y by negative 1. Now, if you think about it, that actually makes the sprite move down. When you move in a negative direction, that's going down. But what this is going to do is make sure our character is first touching the platform. And if so, then we're going to jump up. So add an if block right below the change y block. If touching black, then we want to set the y speed to our bounce force. Bounce force was initially set to a value of 10. This will cause the sprite to jump quickly up away from the platform. And then we'll add a change y by 1 to finish that function. Remember, our functions don't do anything until we call them. So come back to our main function when green flag clicked and get the jump function call and place it here under the gravity. Let's save our work and hit the green flag. Now when we press the up arrow, our character jumps. Okay, that's it for the first video in this two-part series. So far, we've created our player sprite. We have our main green flag function, which is kind of like the game engine. And then we have four other my blocks, which I also call custom functions. We have home, move, gravity, and jump. And altogether, these functions allow our character to move right and left, to jump. And when we fall off a block, we go back to the home position. And if we can get over here to the far right, if we move off to the far right, we go to the next backdrop or the next level of the game. However, when we hit this lava area, the game doesn't end as it should. Also, we need to add some way to earn points. So we're going to add little gold coins, and whenever you collect those, you earn points. And I'm going to show you how to do that in the next video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.